This EMACS script, factor.sh, brute force factors a large semi-prime. The script is in the description below. Okay, it took 5 seconds. Now, let's start 4 threads, each running the same factorization. As everyone knows, EMACS only makes progress on 1 thread at a time. So the total time required is 4 times that required for a single thread. If you're asking yourself, then what are EMACS threads good for? Well, the answer is they're good for nothing. Well, nothing much. Some geezer uses threads to make the EMACS newsreader non-blocking. What people don't realize is there's an optional third argument to the makeThread primitive that jailbreaks the thread from the so-called global interpreter lock. So yeah, while the user time is still 20 CPU seconds, the real time elapsed was roughly a quarter of that, which means 4 CPU cores were utilized. What code changes made this happen? I won't make the mistake of talking over my slide, when reading it quietly is all the audience can do to digest it. Pause the video now, and I promise to shut up until you unpause. So like a certain former commander-in-chief, I declare mission accomplished, when in fact a separate UX thread is still a long ways off. But generally available multithreading was never my goal, nor should it be yours. I mean, if you're watching this obscure video, chances are, not enough is going on in your life that you need more than one core. Rather, the goal is convincing people I might know what I'm doing, and to centralize future EMACS development around a GitHub repo. I don't need everyone to come along, just the bytecode guy, and the guy who fixes the spelling errors. Then, when we've reached critical mass, we start showing ads, so I can finally move out of my mom's basement.